Hey everybody, it's Brittany with Divine Bloom and welcome back to my channel. Here at Divine Bloom, we are all about growing in God and staying rooted in God. So if you're looking for practical ways to grow in God and to stay rooted in God, then this channel is for you. So please do me a favor and hit that like and subscribe button. This way you'll be the first to be notified when new videos are released. So today we are talking about spiritual laziness. Yes, spiritual laziness. What exactly is spiritual laziness? Laziness is the lack of desire for the things of God. Let me say that again. It's the lack of desire for the things of God. So it looks like this. You just don't feel like praying. You just don't feel like reading the Bible. You don't feel like worshiping. You don't feel like fasting. You just have no desire whatsoever for the things of God. That's spiritual laziness. And listen, this is a very dangerous place to be. And you know what? The enemy, he wants you to stay in this state of spiritual laziness because he knows that you will not be effective when you're spiritually lazy. So on today, I want to be your cheerleader. I want to be your coach. If I had a whistle, I would blow the whistle. And I want to sound the alarm. It's time to wake up and break out of that spirit of laziness, all right? So on today, I want to share with you 4 practical tips, and I'm talking practical, like you can implement them today as soon as this video is over. 4 practical tips to combat and fight laziness, spiritual laziness, all right? So stay tuned. All right, spiritual coach Brittany is in the game. I'm ready. We are ready to fight this spiritual laziness. So let's start with the first practical tip that you can implement to start fighting this spiritual laziness. Are you ready for it? All right, so the first tip that I have for you is to learn to speak to your soul. Yes, speak to your soul. I know that sounds a little bit crazy, but let me explain. See, this is a biblical principle. In Psalms 103, David, he did this. He spoke to his soul. He said, "Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and all that is within me. Bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, oh my soul, and forget not his benefits." What David was doing, he was encouraging himself. He was speaking to his soul. He was being his own spiritual hype man. And every now and then, you have to encourage and hype your own self up in the spirit. Okay, so when I find myself not wanting to pray or not wanting to read my Bible, I hype myself up. I say, "Brittany, you know what? God has been too good to you. He's been too merciful to you. He's been too kind to you. He's opened up doors for you. He's made ways out of no ways. He's given you a sound mind. He healed you. You are going to bless the Lord. You are going to pray. You are going to read the Bible because God is worthy of it. He deserves it." So every now and then you have to speak to your soul. Okay, so that's my first practical tip. Okay, so the second practical tip that I have for you in fighting this spiritual laziness is to actually develop a routine, all right? You need a plan of action. You need to set aside time each day to spend time with God, all right? And what I recommend is start off easy. Start off with a 5x5x5 plan. And let me explain what it is. So every day for 5 minutes, you're going to spend time in worship, just telling God, you know, you're faithful, you're worthy, you're awesome, you're an amazing God. I thank you, Lord. Just time in worship, just time reflecting on who he is. All right, so that's for 5 minutes. And then for another 5 minutes, you're going to spend time in your Bible, just reading a verse. And if you're looking for a reading plan, head over to www.mydivinebloom.com and we have a reading plan there. But you want to do this for 5 minutes. Just read for 5 minutes and really think about what you're reading, okay? So that's for 5 minutes. And then another 5 minutes, you want to spend in prayer, all right? And this is just time where you communicate with God, where you tell him what's on your heart, and then you pause and listen to see what it is that he wants to say with you, all right? I know that this may seem small, you know, just 5 minutes, 5 minutes here, 5 minutes there, 5 minutes there, 5x5x5. It doesn't seem like much, but let me tell you this, small steps, they lead to giant leaps. So it may seem small, but what you're doing is you're developing discipline, and we need discipline to break free from spiritual laziness. All right. So that's my second practical tip. All right. So the third practical tip that I have for you for fighting against spiritual laziness is to learn to take care of your physical health and your mental health. world, okay? We are made up of mind, body, and soul. So they're interrelated. So if you neglect to take care of your physical health and your mental health, guess what? It's going to spill over into your spiritual health. 1 Corinthians 6:19, it says that our bodies are temples of the Holy Spirit. I don't know about you, but I want to honor God with my body. We only get one, so we need to be a good steward over what God has given us. So make sure that you're getting, you know, enough sleep, enough rest, and that you're exercising, and that you're hydrated. You want to honor God with your body, all right? So that's a way to fight spiritual laziness. Take care of your physical health and your mental health. All right, so my fourth and final practical tip to fight and to combat spiritual laziness is to consider your relationship with God a gift and a treasure. Oftentimes, we consider our relationship with God sometimes as a burden, something, you know, that we have to do, like, oh, I have to read my Bible, I have to pray, I have to spend time with God. But listen, it is an honor and it is a privilege to serve God. When I started to look at my relationship like that, like, God, I thank you that I get to serve you. I thank you that I know you. I thank you that I belong to you. When you look at your relationship as something that you need to do, something that you get to do, instead of something that you have to do, the game changes. All right, so change your perspective on how you view your relationship with God. It's an honor. It's a privilege to know and to serve God. All right, guys, so those are my four practical tips. I want you to implement them starting today, okay? And again, I want you to be on guard against this spirit, this spiritual laziness, because the enemy, he wants you to be ineffective, but there is so much work to do in the kingdom of God. So it's time for us to wake up, shake off this laziness. There's work to do in the kingdom of God. Let's get to it, all right? Well, guys, you know what I need you to do. I need you to continue to stay rooted in God, all right? I love you so much, and we will talk again very soon. Peace.